my channel. I'm Gabrielle. I'm an actor, I'm an arts educator, and I'm a first-time working mom. Welcome to my workspace where I work with Mercedes, either awake or asleep. This is where I record my podcast, What Are Friends For? If you want to know what that's all about, the link is below. These are my like canceling out blue light glasses that I wear when the long days on the computer and whatnot. You can also check that link on where I got those glasses. Use my code. It's right here. Mercedes is 4 months when I'm recording this video, and a huge part of my pregnancy story was in isolation during the pandemic of 2020, as well as continuing in 2021 now as a mom. And I went to YouTube and watched a lot of mom videos to just get tips, hear, just like be a soundboard, just listen, be a fly on the wall, observe, and also just keep feeling like someone was in my house while I was in isolation, pregnant and breastfeeding. So I hope this is for you. You can also follow my channel. You can subscribe. You can also click the little thumbs up because it gets other people to see this video. And today I'm going to talk about being a first time working mom. So I'm in my recording studio where I record my What Are Friends For podcast, as well as a lot of voiceover auditions and self tapes. I'm a working actress. So my first big experience in isolation mostly made me concentrate on finding a workspace for myself that I could have my dog be comfortable when I was pregnant, as well as now Mercedes, who you can hear in the background in a little bit. She's on her play mat and she's in her grab everything and put it to her mouth stage. But this space was really important to make it really, really exciting to enter every single time. I would get dressed. I put on like, you know, mascara if I want to. And I really, really make it a point to make it feel like a workspace. So there's a desk in here. There's a light in here for, you know, to be able to like make sure that, you know, downlighting isn't just like making me feel like not my best on camera. So a big tip for you that I can offer is make your workspace exciting to go to and also comfortable, like a plate, like make sure you have water there so you're hydrating, and also, you know, a boppy. And I am a firm believer in not traveling things from my house to my workspace. I have a boppy at my workspace and I also have a boppy at home. And also when it comes to diapers and a breast pump and a playpen, it was really important to me to not feel like I would have to just like make this huge long list of things to travel back and forth from home to work. And so I made sure that if somebody donated more than one, which they did, some of my friends donated more than one playpen to me, I said thank you and I took it. Another thing that I learned while I became a first-time working mom is my space for work is my own. I'm not sharing it with other colleagues, especially even more so now, still in isolation. It's August in 2021 and Los Angeles numbers are still a little bit like, you know, keep your mask on and all things like that. So I'm still kind of keeping people at arm's length with Mercedes, my baby, to be around. And so, with the workspace that is not from home, I got a basic, standard, non-fancy pack play for the office. What we do right now, it may sound, you know, not super fancy, but it really doesn't have to be. Babies just need to eat, need you, and they need sleep. You know what I mean? Like it's pretty, pretty basic for them in their infancy. And so I got a playpen just for the office space, and we put it in my husband's closet that has a little bit more shade. When we put the blinds down in his office, it's still a little bright in there. And so we just put it in the entryway of the closet. It's a really, really big storage closet, and there's not tons of storage in there. I have like a clothing rack there with shoes. We have a bookshelf with a lot of like, you know, extra things to refresh for his whenever he's on stage. And I keep a change of clothes here because for my podcast, I'm always changing different looks. Sometimes we record multiple episodes per day, so we just like to change our top or whatever to make it just look different. And so I made some space to let Mercedes have a really solid nap, because sometimes the travel from home to work is about 18-minute drive, and she'll sleep those 10 minutes, but a 10-minute nap, if you don't know yet, a 10-minute nap does not suffice in her routine. It has to be at least 30 minutes, and sometimes she'll go for 90 minutes, but if I can get her to sleep for 30 minutes, then her routine and her cycle to sleep better at night really, really works. So it's important for me that I learned that she just needs to sleep really well. her first month, 2 months of being on this earth, she slept well on the floor or by my side in a Dock-a-Tot. But once she started learning that, once she started gaining core strength, leg strength, and she started rocking and rolling to her sides, the Dock-a-Tot actually would wake her up because she could not turn to her side in it. So, yes, those are really, really awesome that you can feel that they're safe. So you can put them on a couch or on a bed or, you know, somewhere near you and you feel like they're, you know, not going to go anywhere. But once she started rolling to her sides and started understanding her core strength, I had to reinvent her nap routine, which was the pack and play. And the one I had was a very reasonable price, very, very simple, and I got it at Target. So I'll drop that link below so you can see which one I have. So we don't have a big house. We have a really small condo here in Los Angeles. And so when I work in the space that I do that is off location from our house, it's actually really, really big. There's a kitchen here and there's even like a mother's nursing room here, which is amazing. But then I realized like that's a lot of walking around and traveling. So the one thing I would like to recommend that I learned is even if you do have a separate space in your house that is an office space and you have your baby with you, create a changing station that is mobile. There are really great little collapsible caddies that you can just put diapers, wipies, a change of clothes, you know, socks, because babies always just lose socks, and an extra passy. And I would just carry that with me, whatever room we're in. And so if she ever needs a change of clothes, we don't need to spend time walking somewhere else or tracking everything. And so that became really, really helpful and really cut a lot of time. And the final thing that I want to share that I've learned so far in the 4 months of my motherhood, the 4 months of having a baby, is grace and patience. You know, take a deep breath and just remember that every day is different. Every day with Mercedes, adapting and, you know, and taking care of her as well as taking care of all the deadlines that I have with my work, it's gonna be okay if they're not perfect. And that might sound like super easy and a big like, duh, that makes complete sense. Why would I have to be told that? But I have to remind myself about that every single day because her routine is changing. There are sleep regressions coming up. I like to think of them as sleep progressions because she is progressing in her strength and in her age and in her, you know, intellect. And so it just, you gotta roll literally with her and with her punches to just accommodate to when she wakes up. You know, unfortunately, if she wakes up in the middle of a huge deadline or a huge Zoom call or whatever, it's okay. You know, we are adapting to our new world that's virtual more than ever before. And I have to remind myself to take a deep breath and just be like, hey guys, 1 second, I just need to take care of my baby. I will be right back. And just like rock her with the camera off or take care of her and then finish the conversation on the email. And so I've had to give myself a lot of grace on that too, especially with voiceover deadlines, because I'm recording with a microphone. Bless you. I'm recording with the microphone and I have to have a quiet space. And if she's here and I'm doing like an audition or an actual job with, you know, the client on Zoom and I'm recording to be able to send them material as best as possible, you know, sometimes it doesn't work out at the specific time that I scheduled. And then when she takes a nap, I need to eat, guys. You know what I mean? Like we have to eat and hydrate and stuff. So just be kind to yourself, take care of yourself, because it is so true that you must take care of yourself before you can take care of her. And then you can take care of each other. And the day goes even better that way. And sometimes if you got to finish your work at 9 p.m., mentally prepare yourself for that during the day and have a restful state of mind instead of just burning all of your energy by the time she goes to bed to wrap up all your work. So that's the last thing I'll talk about when it comes to learning how to work with a baby in the same space is that late night work, that late night working block schedule does really come in handy if you mentally prepare yourself and conserve your energy and be hydrated throughout the day so you can feel like you can really give it your all at that time of night after a little bit of food. So I appreciate you all being here. I appreciate this being a part of your journey of you just trying to discover and work things out. Again, every mama's journey is so different and highly respected because we are all catering to our own schedules, our own babies, all of their energies, and our own environments. So I hope this is helpful for you. Do you hear her poop? She just pooped. That means I have to go. She just pooped. So that means I have to go. And I just want to say thanks for watching this video, and I'll see you on the next one.